100-acre wood lived a small fellow named Piglet. His proudest possession was a scrapbook filled with drawings of him and his friends on their biggest adventures. Let's begin now. Piglet was home finishing his scrapbook when his friends passed by. Eeyore, Tigger, Pooh, and Rabbit each carried strange tools. Piglet was curious and followed them.
What are you all doing?
The gang had a big plan to collect honey. Rabbit planned to attract bees with music as Eeyore lured them into a new hive held by Tigger. Pooh would collect the honey. Piglet was eager to take part.
Can I help you with your big plan?
His friends felt Piglet would not be helpful. Tigger tried to let him down easy.
When we have a bit smaller of a plan, or when you're a bit bigger of a piglet.
All but Piglet took their places as Rabbit began playing his violin. The music was so painful, it made the bees sting them. Piglet tried to alert Pooh of the approaching swarm.
Oh, do the bees know the plan?
Forget. Don't get in the way of our big plan.
Piglet distracted the swarm to protect his friends, but the bees turned on him. Thinking quickly, Piglet funneled the bees into a fake hive. When the gang finished harvesting the honey, they all congratulated each other. All but Piglet.
But I was the...
Rabbit felt bad.
Oh, Piglet, I'm sorry that you couldn't be part of our big plan.
Piglet wandered off to the woods, daydreaming.
It'd sure be nice if my friends needed me.
The rest of the gang celebrated the success of their honey harvest when Pooh noticed the fake hive shaking.
Did you hear something?
Suddenly, the angry contents burst out. Rabbit ordered everyone to escape.
It's your honey or your life.
Once everyone was safely indoors, Rabbit did a head count.
Tigger's here, Eeyore's here, Pooh is here, I'm here. Who am I forgetting?
Pooh stood on a desk to help himself to Piglet's honey pot. Off balance, Pooh spilled himself, along with Piglet's scrapbook, onto the floor. Tigger helped Pooh up.
Hey, what do we have here? What's that tiny pink dot?
Rabbit strained to see the drawing.
I believe it's Piglet.
Chased by the bees.
Pooh initiated a new plan.
We have to find him and make sure he's all right. Think. Since this is a book of Piglet's memories, maybe it remembers where Piglet is.
Always the practical one, Rabbit protested.
That's the silliest thing I've ever heard.
Well, page one remembers Owl's house.
So, on they went. Within moments after his friends left, Piglet returned to the honey harvest, shocked to find the grounds a mess.
Eeyore? Where are you? Tigger?
Oh no, the bees!
What can I do?
Knowing that this was his big chance to prove himself, he confidently marched off.
Maybe my friends need me. I have to find them.
The gang arrived at Owl's and hoped that he had a quick answer for them regarding Piglet's whereabouts.
Piglet? Of course I've seen Piglet many times. He's about so high with little pink ears and a curly tail.
Not getting anywhere with Owl, Rabbit pushed the gang out the door as Owl rambled on.
I told you this was a silly idea.
Tigger and Eeyore were not ready to give up.
But he was just at Owl's. That scrappity book does know where he's going. How about page two, which is a picture of...
Rabbit interrupted and made the idea his own.
Kanga's house is where we'll look for Piglet.
As the gang walked towards Kanga's house, Pooh reminded them that they were all afraid of Kanga when she and Roo first moved into the 100-acre wood. Rabbit and Pooh recall the time they swapped out Piglet for Roo, hoping to learn more about their new neighbors.
You know, if it weren't for Piglet,
we'd never have found out how nice Kangaroo was.
Tigger robustly embraced Kanga at her door.
We're so glad you didn't leave.
What are you talking about, Tigger?
Rabbit cut Tigger off.
How Piglet took a bath for us.
Not just any old buddy do something that prayed for his friend. It was the very biggest thing for a littlish guy to do.
Pooh explained how they lost Piglet and how the scrapbook was helping them find him. Roo joined the search party.
Page 3 shows all of us at the North Pole.
The friends could not agree which way to go. Pooh looked for answers.
Perhaps if we told the story would tell us how to get there.
Don't forget the part about Piglet.
Oh, Roo's right. It really is a story about Piglet, isn't it?
The pictures told the tale of Christopher Robin leading the expedition to find the North Pole, although no one knew where or what it was. On the way, Roo fell into a river. Piglet saved Roo using a stick, which he later handed to Pooh. Pooh recalled how the gang celebrated him because they thought he found the North Pole.
Hooray for Pooh! I always liked that story. It is such a lovely end.
Roo felt sorry.
Someone so small.
Thank you, Piglet. Wherever you are.
Pooh was startled when Roo made a discovery.
Piglet's scarf!
Oh my. You know Piglet's scarf never goes anywhere without Piglet.
You think he's gonna be alright?
Piglet shall be very alright indeed. Don't let his small size worry you.
Eeyore agreed.
Yep. Once he even made a whole house.
Pooh explained the pictures in the scrapbook that illustrated his and Tigger's failed attempts, then Piglet's success in building a house for Eeyore. Roo was in awe.
You mean Piglet built Eeyore's house all by himself?
Yes, and that's just how much Piglet cares.
The area was dubbed Pooh Corner, even though it was Piglet's idea. The search party was more determined than ever to find Piglet and picked up the pace. Tigger jumped into action.
Hey, I just got a terrific idea. Let's see where the book ends and go there.
It started to rain. Tigger grabbed the book to keep Rabbit from smearing the pictures.
Rabbit, your book. You're ruining it, Rabbit.
In their struggle, the book was heartbroken to have lost the book and Piglet's memories. Suddenly, remembering how cold and wet they were, they returned to Piglet's to get warm. As they headed out, Pooh found one of the pictures from Piglet's book. He sadly noticed it was from the house at Pooh Corner.
I do wish I had called it Pooh Piglet Corner.
The storm continued outside, but the friends stayed warm inside. Roo drew a picture of Piglet in the window condensation. Pooh added a smile.
That's the Piglet I know. Always glad to see you.
The friends took turns praising their friend.
Always thoughtful.
Always brave.
Never thinking of himself.
They continued drawing more of their memories on paper, surrounding themselves with their favorite memories of Piglet. The pictures warmed their hearts and brought new energy to their search. Roo led the way.
We gotta go get Piglet!
Let's go!
The search party retraced their steps to the bridge. Rabbit stopped in his tracks.
Look! Oh, look what I found!
Pooh was overjoyed.
It's one of Piglet's scrapbook pages.
Hoping to rebuild the book to help them find Piglet, the group scurried all over, collecting pages. Tigger called the others over to help him get the scrapbook that hung from a log on the side of a cliff.
Hey,
That's gotta be dangerous. What could he be thinking?
Pooh climbed out on the log, but then slipped through a hole.
Oh, bother, bother.
The rest lined up to form a rescue rope to reach out and save Pooh. Rabbit worried that it wasn't long enough.
Oh, dear. Who can help?
Out of nowhere, Piglet appeared and bounced his way down the chain. Tigger urged him on.
We're all counting on you, Piglet.
My friends need me. Hang on, Pooh.
Pooh was happier than anyone to see Piglet and Hermit. Unfortunately, the little extra weight caused the log to break. And Pooh and Piglet disappeared. For their two lost friends, unaware that Pooh and Piglet safely rolled out the other side of the log. Pooh approached Rabbit and Tigger.
Something must be very sad.
Well, of course it's sad.
Pooh?
Oh, thank goodness you're safe.
Everyone celebrated Pooh and Piglet's safe return. Despite their efforts, the scrapbook was not saved. So the friends all rushed to Piglet's house to show him the pictures they drew for him. Piglet loved them. To celebrate, they threw a big Piglety party. During the celebration, Pooh unveiled a new sign at Pooh Corner. Piglet read the sign aloud.
Pooh and Piglet Corner.
Yes, Piglet. It's the least we could do for a very small Piglet who's done such very big things.
Now they all knew that everyone, no matter how small, plays a big part of any plan.